Today we are going to play Isengard against Hard Army Mordor on a beautiful map to Hero in Battle for Middle Earth 1 on the patch 2.2 to the Dwarven mod, and I would love to see the changes they have implemented into the new Isengard, the White Hand. Unfortunately, we are picking Grave for whatever reason, because the Hard Army wanted to pick White, I guess. Alright, Dune Hero is a map from top to bottom. I believe you have seen this already many, many times. We have the Uruk-hai at the beginning of the game, and we will be building two furnaces at the start, just to get as much money as we potentially can. From the heroes, we have one single new hero, and that's Ugluk. We have Lurtz for the same price, and Saruman for the same price. So looks like not much is changed. English is hard once again. And the reason why I was picking Mordor opponent is simple, because we have seen in the last video, Rohan was quite buggy, and I don't want to have a buggy game again. Because Rohan will close the gate, and they won't know the way of getting out of the castle anymore, you know? Alright, build Lammermuir at the beginning of the game. You have also the chance to build Dunland Camp, which is going to be like a production building, which you can build offensively. Very interesting. We might actually build this here just to test it out. PowerPoint-wise, it looks pretty much the same, but we have also Storm of Orphang. It summons a controllable lightning storm for 3 power points only, damages and slow units. The freezing rain, fuel the fires, and Saruman of many colors. Grant Saruman additional health, damage, and new set of powerful abilities with 12 power points. So it's cheaper than the tower we were unlocking with the Mordor faction in the previous video. I believe it was like 18, if I'm not mistaken. So, at the beginning of the game, once again, we will focus on the resource income just to make sure that we have, you know, a great amount of money all the time. And also, let's build the Dunland camp. I believe we will get the chance to recruit additional units. And let's go forward. Remember, Uruks are the fastest, the strongest, and the best looking swordsmen in the game. Look at their thieves, guys. They were just visiting the dentist, I believe. You know, the white thieves. That's crazy. Uruks have whiter thieves than humans. Confirmed. Let's deal some damage, shall we? Okay, we are cash floating. Let's build one more furnace. And then let's recruit Uruk. Ugluk. For 1100, he's a bit cheaper than Lurtz. I'm actually curious if he's as impactful as Lurtz. Here are orcs. But this is not a rubble of mindless orcs. These are Uruk-hai. Their armor is thick and their shields broad. Okay, here we will... This is actually building up extremely slow in compared to all the other structures we are building so far. We will be focusing down the mill first in the shield wall formation to get more tanky. And soonish, we will get the chance to recruit the Dunlanding Rebel for 100. Fast but disorganized Rebel, useful for raiding, gain upgrades with levels and level weak versus calf and archers. And they're also getting fast recruited, which kind of makes sense because the building takes ages to be built up. Oh my goodness, he's attacking us already. Let's go for Ugluk. Ugluk, I need you, brother. I need you. I don't want to lose this mill though, but I believe Ugluk won't be there in time. Actually, yeah, he will. Also, Ugluk is being recruited extremely fast. Alright, these are the Dunlanding Rebel. They have also the chance to go for the War Leader with level 2, 15% more damage, experience gain, fear resistance, acts as a banner carrier. They have the scavenge armor for 30% increased armor, and last but not least, the torches significantly increases damage against buildings. Say no more. Ugluk looks like that. He has the Orc Draught, heals nearby Uruks for a small amount, and also increases speed by 5% for 45 seconds. And then, Commanding Roar. 10% damage, attack, and fear resistant to nearby units for 45 seconds. So the buff is kind of meh, to be honest with you guys. We actually won this fight. Okay, of course we won this fight, because Uruks are stronger. But I can't say the same about the Dunlandings. I mean, it kind of makes sense, I guess, because they cost only 100. But losing this mill kind of hurts. So let's build one more furnace, and then the next hero on the list, of course, is going to be the legendary Lurtz. The brother of Ugluk, I'm assuming. I believe every Uruk is a brother from another mother, you know? Okay. So let's see, let's go for a limit testing with Ugluk. He has nothing like Carnage or something like this. Also, his damage output is kind of meh. I believe he will need ages to kill this Warclan, and by the time he kills the one Orc Warc and the other one, the first one is going to respawn already, you know? Extremely slow and also taking tons of damage, but he's level 2 now. Can I heal myself also with this one? Very curious. Yeah, kind of a little bit. For 45 seconds, we get also more movement speed. Anyways, we have now enough money for Lourdes. That's good. Also, this mid is going to be taken down. So, we are able to deal great amount of economical damage. I will recruit one more of these and then demolish the building to build another Lamrim mill. Because I'm kind of disappointed in these downlanding rebels. We will need Lourdes to creep the Vorklinger and build more furnaces. I mean, it looks like we will get the chance to recruit Saruman regardless. But it sounds like that he will get a new command set. Like new abilities once we have the 12 power points unlocked from the spellbook of Isengard. Lourdes is looking pretty much the same. Has cripple. Oh, Ugluk. Don't get killed by orc archers, I'm telling you. We can turn in the fight. I'm starving. We hadn't anything to eat, but, you know, make it a break. Make it a bread for three stinking days. Oh, looks like they can't... That is... Oh, that is Gollum, that's why. Gollum is so small here. Holy moly, Gollum is so small. Not even targetable. We will be able to win this fight with Lourdes' help, of course. We have some more units behind. And let's build full furnaces. First of all, now you might call me crazy. And you might say, Shanks, where are your units at? And that's a great question. But we have our outposts here. We can capture this. And oh wait, hold on a second. Okay. Ugluk, go, 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 go. We need to build it now. Looks like the outpost is the same. The factions changes are not quite a lot, to be honest with you. The power points is a little bit different. And of course, they will get the chance to recruit additional heroes and also units. Mordo received lots of changes, though, to the Orc Pit and also to the Mumakil Khan, as well as to the Haradrim Palace. The power points are also looking completely different. You have no chance of recruiting a flying hero early on, but you can recruit a flying hero later on. So let's creep this. Let's kill this, I mean. Let's get a Lamrim mill here and also get this outpost captured. Here... And we might take a look into the Uruk pit and double furnace. Okay. And here we can buy this outpost. Just to get a bit more money. Please. Okay. Nice. We have still this Lamrim mill under our control. It makes us kind of great and rich, you know? Ugluk is almost dead. So Ugluk, you peel back. Heal up yourself over time. But there is a huge army coming very soon. We have also these units. Isengard scouts for 600. But how they are scouts when they cost so much? Let's go for the crossbowmen. They cost the same, they cost the same, they cost the same, and also they cost the same. But we are getting over run. Let's build the Isengard keep only for 490. The reason is simple, because we have so much wood bonus at this point, and that makes our structures generally much, much cheaper. Double of them, and let's build a tower right off the bat. Talking about towers, we will need more in our castle. Okay? That's the plan. So our heroes are kind of badly damaged. So let's try to lure them inside our castle, I guess. And let the towers do the rest. The keep is ready. Okay. This way, we have a protection from this side. Remember, the only way our opponent might attack us is either this pathway or this pathway. So with this outpost, we kind of get lots of vision control. But also block the enemy's entrance to our side of the map. With the towers, you know, this has been taken down, but it's okay. Lourdes is almost level 3. That's gonna unlock the carnage. What is that actually? Looks very strange to me. Doesn't look... Oh, there is a troll. He has already a troll on his field. Okay. Right, looks like it's also a bit tankier. Warchant, Palantir. I wanna go for this one. Because that's new, you know? Okay, the furnace has been taken down. Or will be taken down eventually. That's okay though. You guys, please take care of this troll ASAP. Lourdes, do your thing. Hurry up. Ugluk, go, 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 my friends. Go, go, go. Can you guys also help out a little bit? Would be awesome. Because we have not many units. The troll has been taken down. That's great news. Let's get one more Urukai to get the Uruk pit to level 2 for the Berserkers. We will zoom in up very, very soon into the units just to see how they are looking like. Lourdes, just use your sword, my friend. Okay, these are the Uruks, I believe. Our crossbowmen are looking like that. I believe not too much is changed about their design. And also Lourdes is looking pretty much the same, right? No, he looks a bit better. Looks a bit better. They can take it down. Don't destroy my Uruk pit, man. Come on now. We expanded the Uruk pit. You can also combine them, I believe, right? Yeah, you can also combine them just like a normal battle for Middle-earth 1. And they have the steel draw stings. 10% pierce damage. And no fire arrow. With overdraw, crossbow bolts knock back infantry targets for 25 seconds. Purchase the steel drawstrings upgrade to enable. Heavy armor, forge blades, and no fire arrows, by the way. No fire arrows, which is kind of meh against structures. That's how the berserkers are looking like. Pretty good, pretty good. We are under attack on this side, but it's okay. We have also enough money for Saruman. Let's recruit him right off the bat. We also need to send our heroes now to this side, because the towers are made of paper. They are dying extremely fast. But we have now the Storm of Orphang. We can use it right here. Okay, Saruman is singing. Nice. I mean, that's no damage, by the way. Okay, we need Crossbow Man. Let's go, Crossbow Man. Let's use the formation and let's send them here. Let's demolish one of the furnaces inside the base. This way we can build the armory to purchase all the upgrades we need. Lords, go, my friend. Uglu, go, my friend. Guys, defend this, please. Okay. Here, let's build a work pit and also... Tower. Just build a tower. Actually, this is lasting also quite a long time. And I believe you can... Nah, you cannot use it for scouting. It's extremely slow. And I believe it doesn't even give you vision. There is a Nazgul. Let's cripple him down. Another Nazgul is coming. Oh, that's a Witch King, by the way. Let's use Carnage. Let's limit his Lord's damage. Lord's is dealing almost no damage against Nazgul, by the way. Let's use this. Okay. And Lord's will be able to kill him. Nice. Level 5 instantly. But Witch King is a different story. And talking about Witch King, there is also a troll coming. Run, you fools. Run, you fools. I'm trying to run away as soon as much as I can. What is that? Okay, we will lose both the heroes right here. We lost both of them. And troll actually got level 5 after that. Holy guacamole. Oh, we lost them, right? Yeah, we cannot even... Oh, we have 9,000? Brother, 9,000? Rip. We will never be able to revive him. We lost the outpost and this is not looking good for your boy. The troll is just like doesn't care and going inside the jeans. 9,000? I'm not leaving. I'm not leaving. We need industry though, because we need money. And look at this industry. It's bigger because now you can hit like 4 structures almost, right? I don't know. Warp pit looks the same. Oh, I made a mistake. I built a work pit here. I wanted to build armory though. Kind of rusty. Okay. We have work to do. Indeed, my friend Saruman. You and me, baby. You and me. We can rule Middle-earth together. If you want to, of course. No force, by the way. No rush. I mean, our money is not looking that great because we have lost a lot of map control. Indeed, we have only one single lumber mill outside, which is not enough to do what we are looking for, and that's of course making an army worthy of Mordor, or worthy to face against Mordor. That's the original plan of the scheme. And also let's recruit them. Elite infantry proficient with swords and bow. I believe they are like an elven warrior from the Rohan faction, which are able to switch between swords and bows. There is the Witch King coming, ladies and gentlemen. Right, that's Witch King, right? On almost level 7, holy guacamole. What is that? Leadership bonus. Pretty bad one, to be honest. So let's steal the enemy units, I believe. The Witch King doesn't care, my boy. Can I kill this Witch King? Come on. Kill this, kill this. Don't run, Witch King, don't run. Why are you running, Witch King? Witch King! Please kill him, It didn't... Guys, did you see that? It dealt zero damage to Witch King. Zero damage to Witch King. He's even healing after that, you know? Can I cripple him? Yeah, you are able to cripple him. I was like confused for a single second. Oh my goodness, what is this fiesta? What is this absolute clown fiesta? Okay, boys, we need fire arrows. It's called fire arrow. And also now you can also get this one for 1400. I don't know, everything is so expensive and we are kind of broken. Oh, Lourdes, what are you doing, my friend? Let's use this here. Saruman! Stop singing, Saruman. Start fighting, Saruman. Okay, let's use this. Okay, we need assistance, boys. Okay, the troll has been finally taken down. That's good. Just before he goes down, he also knocks down the Saruman on the ground like a madman. We need power points. Okay. Lords has leadership, which is 20% damage only. Holy moly. They don't like Lords in this mod. He costs the same, but gives you only 20% damage. It's a joke. And looks like we can't even give this guy fire arrow, right? But what we need to do now is actually... Let's go for the field of fires, guys. I am feeling it. We need money. We need money. We don't care about leadership bonuses from our opponent just yet. We will need money. You fool! He's destroying our furnaces. Destroying them. But they are so tanky. They have 4,500 health. A bit, but level 2. Okay, never mind. Okay, level 10. Storm. Reduces production speed and resource output for an enemy building while damaging it. Lasts for 60 seconds. So it's like a thing against enemy units. Enemy buildings, apparently. And not against enemy units. But it's okay. We have now enough money. Let's do that. With the help of industry, we should also... I mean, with the help of the field of fires, we should also get a lot of money. You guys can also creep the war clan maybe at the bottom left side. If the creep is still around, of course. And we can get a bit more money. What is the purpose of the... fire upgrade from the armory? If you can't even buy it on the units. That's what I want to know. You can buy it on the Isengard scouts. That's why... You can also give them forge blades and panel. That's how they are looking like. I want to see their design. They are looking pretty good. Pretty good. Guys, can you please take down this ram? That'd be awesome. The ram is apparently extremely tanky. Let's give them this, this. Oh, Lord, what is Lord doing? Oh, I was not paying attention. Lord, please don't die. I'm still speechless, by the way. 9,000 to revive Ugluk, my friends. 9,000 to revive Ugluk. You fall. Boom, sun on your face. And then you go ham for the Visa Blast. You are weak. Fool. Boom. 2 power points collected. We have only... we are only 10 power points away. I don't know what happened at the bottom left side. I can't see. We have everything purchased. Let's demolish the armory. Let's recruit a couple of more of these. And also let's go for the Warg Riders. Okay, we are actually getting bullied all the time. There is a Nazgul slowly but surely walking his way up to us. Let's get this. Forge blades. Okay, let's try to fight this. You can see there are many things missing. Like, you can tell and say that they have heavy armor or something. And that's, I believe, more important. Like, the visual things for you to understand and see as a player is more important than the look from anything. I don't care about look as much as about the balance. And the balance is only possible if you are able to see. Imagine you don't see the animation of the cripple, you know? In which you can't tell if they are crippled or not. Okay. More units are required. Warg Riders, they cost a lot. Hold on a second. Saruman has leadership, right? But leadership is kind of meh. And Lurtz's leadership is even worse. The Warchan is the same, okay. Victory is at hand. I want to see the new abilities from Saruman once he's level 10. Maybe he will have a stronger leadership. Who knows? Come to me, my creatures. Literally, his creatures. Okay, we need more. I don't know. I'm not very, you know, kind of happy with these units, to be honest, so far. Oh, catapults. I knew it. I knew it. Run. Steal them, Saruman. Steal one of them. Okay. Oh, he has so many of them. Holy guacamole. What we are gonna do now? What is... Oh, we need Warg Riders. Yeah, yeah. We need Warg Riders to kill them. A new power is rising. And victory is at hand. He's dodging us. You know? He's dodging us. Okay, we are actually losing a lot of HP from the catapults. Drama trolls. Mordor is going to war, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, we need melee units. Uruks, we need to kill those catapults ASAP. They are actually on the hand, they want to kill our Saruman. Can you please fight this? No? You don't want to fight? If it's no problemo, please fight this. Without fire arrows, as you can see, we are dealing zero damage to the catapults. But they are clamped like this, we can fireball them. Fireball this. Should be able to kill both. Yeah, nice. That's what I wanted. But in the meantime, we are being surrounded, ladies and gentlemen. We are being surrounded. So Saruman is quite low. And there is another four system coming. So I believe what we gotta do is just make Uruks at this point. Okay, Saruman can use fireball. I mean, these are our units, right? Yeah, okay. There is a Nazgul or a Witch King, rather, right? Is this Witch King? Can't even cripple him sometimes. You lose clicks against him sometimes for whatever reason. Okay, we need to replace the stuff we are losing all the time. And we are losing level 3 furnaces, ladies and gentlemen. This is gonna die. Please kill him, Saruman. Okay, we didn't get lasted with Saruman. Okay, but we have the power points now. And boom, he's turning into Saruman. The picture is the same, but he has the crushing blast. Crush units with a wave of energy. A searing fireball throws a larger ball of fireball. I want to see that. What is that? Command of Mind. Gain control enemy units in a large area. And Mind of Metal and Gears. Leadership bonus. But you see? More leadership bonus now. And Duel of Minds. Damage, disorient, and weaken a hero. Does not affect Aragorn, Gandalf, or the Witch King. Left click, then right click on the target hero. Isengard Unleashed. Okay, increase production speed of target building. All right. Let's test the fireball first. Okay, now he's looking like a truck. That's what I like to see. We are kind of broke, ladies and gentlemen. We have no money. Okay, we have also lost this area for whatever reason. Okay, we need to do some stuff, but it's kind of hard. We need the decision eventually, but for that reason, we need to first of all get the Palantir. Talking about Palantir, let's use it. I want to see what's going on in the mortar base. That's how it looks like. And now we see catapults all around the place. Warten is on cooldown. Doesn't look good for a boy. And also the upgrades for Isengard, they are so extremely expensive. We need heavy armor. Okay, you guys, please recapture this mills. We have like literally one mill outside. That's why we are so broke, you know? There is no speechcraft for this faction. I mean, for Saruman. And also Moisey Dreams, thanks for the follow. Appreciate that. Means a lot to me. What is this lightning happening there? Let's get them heavy armor first and then forge blades. Let's wait for the war chant to be ready. And then we can go for the attack. And hopefully we will be able to destroy this outpost. It's gonna be the goal with this attack, you know? Okay, come on now. Let's use this for now. Try to hold them busy. Come on now, war chant. We need war chant. Isengard looks pretty interesting, not gonna lie. And Warg Riders, maybe... Oh, wait a second. Warg Riders! Look, you see, he's doing some stuff. He's doing something automatically. You see that? You see what he's doing, guys? I don't know what he's doing. I mean, he's doing something. I don't click. He's like passively killing them. For whatever reason. Okay. Let's give them everything what they need. Does he have pillage? The answer is yes. He has pillage. That's good. 6 power points collected. Let's go for the devastation first. Let's use devastation around this side to get money. Let's reclaim the map control as long as we can. Because now what we need to do is destroy this outpost. And also Warg Riders. You gotta make something happen, my friends. Crossbowman here. Okay. They have no chance of getting fire arrows for whatever reason. And these catapults, they hurt. They hurt a lot, by the way. I want to see that level 10, but I want to see the fireball damage against the hero. Let's see that. Let's see. He's almost full HP, right? I mean, this guy is also full HP, but this is a Nazgul, which also is pretty expensive hero. Oh, it hurts. It hurts. Also leaves like fire on the ground. I believe this fire is damaging them even more. Look, he's keeping the distance when he's attacking. That's what it is. Okay, now it makes sense. Okay, Warg Riders, I need you. I need you, brothers. I need you. I need you to kill those catapults. This catapult spammer. He has so many of them. Holy guacamole. And rams too. Let's buy this outpost. You guys peel back. I want to also spam catapults on him, actually, guys. He's tilting me so much. Alright, but Saruman looks pretty fun, to be honest. I think Saruman is quite fun champion or hero in this game. Warcriders! Let's use Warchant to make them a bit stronger. But they can't move because they are getting body blocked hardcore. Can you kill the catapult fast? Yeah, two shots you need still to kill him. Okay, we killed the catapults. I want to kill the double. He has double siege works. That's the problem. Let's use freezing rain to nullify all these leadership bonuses. There is one ram destroying us. For whatever reason. You guys, we combined. There we go. Combine them. Like that. Nice. Alright, Warcriders. Let's kill this. Kill this catapult first, please. For anything else. Catapults are not fun to play against. There is a Nazgul in front of our gate. Or base, rather. This is actually pretty challenging. I don't know. Maybe we need more melee units. By the way. You are weak. Fool! But that's a Witch King, of course. It's a different story. Can you cripple him? The Witch King? So he can't move. You can't cripple him. Really? He can't be crippled? Okay, we killed one Siege Warrix. I didn't pay attention to... Oh, he died. Okay, that's good. We killed only one Siege Warrix. He has now Darkness too. Okay, we need more melee units, ladies and gentlemen. We need more melee units. Because we need some stuff that can take down his Siege Warrix and stuff, you know? So, basically, what I also need is a Siege Warrix eventually. And we also definitely need... Will we lose this fight? We lost this fight already. That's out of question. Saruman! Almost level 10. Almost level 10. Let's use Fireball on the units behind. Lords is almost level 10 too. Doesn't really matter too much. I mean, of course, he will be able to deal more damage, but... Not as important as getting Saruman to level 10. Not nearly as important. Talking about level 10, let's go. What is his army, my friends? What is his army? Saruman, just peel back. Lords has like a very bad leadership ability. Victory is at hand. Let's use this. Actually, this is so hard because the problem is the hard army has so many command points available, you know? That makes it so impossible almost for us to win because they have 800 command points available, guys. That's the problem. And that's why, look how many units he has the chance to recruit all the time. Oh, man. 9,000. I mean, that's buggy. Saruman, don't die. I'm actually, when you think for 9,000 for Ugluk, I believe, you know, Saruman is going to be like 100,000 or something. Some shenanigans. Okay. Let's give them every upgrade they need. We gotta kill those catapults, man. We need to kill these catapults. I mean, it's risky now with Saruman, but it is how it is. Right, guys, you move, please. Fireball. Fireball. Come on, Saruman. Come on, Saruman. Nice. Fireball and run. Run, you fool. He's beefy. He's tanky. He's tanky, kinda tanky. Let's go inside the jeans. Warcriders, where are you guys? They are moving from this area. Okay, he was actually not able to destroy this for whatever reason. But he was able to destroy this also for whatever reason. Level 6 Uruks. Warcriders are here. Go, go, Warcriders. Just destroy the Siege Warrix, please. That's all you... Oh, but there is another massive army. And you can see without the devastating powers... Let's use Blades. Of, you know, like Balrog or Army of the Dead, it's kind of tough to win a 1v1 situation only. That's not even a 1v7 situation, by the way. It's a 1v1 situation only against a hard army. That's kind of busted. That's kind of busted. So I believe what we got to do is spam also units. Even though we have not nearly as much money as this hard army has, you know? But still, we got to spam units on the field all the time. And just try to outclass them, you know? Let heroes give them a bit of time to recover. There we go. The outpost has been taken down. Let's try to destroy his economy a little bit too. Okay, Warcriders can clean up this area. Should be able to win this battle. We need more mills to get the money we need. With the fuel the fires, we will get so much value from it. Okay, you guys. Spam units all the time. Industry is available. Use it the second it's available. Like this. We missed on one. Bad, but it's okay. Let's use whole ability. Let's use formation to make them a bit more tanky. I can't tell which one is better. Like if this Isengard scouts are better or Uruks in a raw 1v1 sword battle. I believe Uruks are better choice. I believe. Can't tell though. Can confirm. Okay, we killed this. That's good. We couldn't kill this. That's not good. Let's use whole ability. Boom. Saruman and Lords are healing up over time. That's dope. And you have to just focus on the map control as well. Let's get this. Nice. Okay. Let's combine them, I guess. Because I hope that he has not enough siege weapons now. But again, combining, you know, maybe it's not the greatest idea because we have no fire damage. Which means we have literally no chance. We are also losing this fight hardcore, by the way. On the right side here. We are actually not. Let's use War Chant and let's try to do something with the orc with the Uruks and War Chant. They have now more DPS. Let's also use Freezing Rain to make the enemy units weaker. Let's combine these clowns. sorry for calling you clowns, Uruks. Combine. There we go. Let's give them armor first. Okay, is one of the Uruk pits level 2 yet? The answer is no. That's not the case. Just use the darkness, but darkness doesn't nullify the effect of freezing rain. So they have still no leadership, and our Uruks are extremely tanky. That's what I like to see. Uruks. Okay. We will be able to destroy this outpost with these two Uruks only. That's good. That's what we needed. Okay, you guys can also keep moving to this side. Just try to do as much you can. Because in the meantime, we also need to move from this side. You are also limited to... Nah, you need to get level 3 for that. Okay, that's what it is. Okay. Look how tanky the Uruks are, guys. Do you see that? That's crazy. They have also Uruks here. You guys, get this. Spam Uruks. I believe that's the right way you want to play that, actually. When I think about it. So let's get these units. And also, let's put them inside the tower here. Just why not? Okay, he's coming now with trolls and stuff. But Saruman is here. Don't you worry, Saruman is here. Saruman, let's do it, my friend. You and me, baby. Boom, son. Fireball. I believe the fire on the ground is able to damage them too. Okay, Saruman actually pretty effective. I like that. But our orcs, Uruks are dying in a second. I don't like that. Kill this, please. Nice. Okay. So we also need to recapture this settlement. Okay. Just go here. Get this mill too. Get this mill too. If once we have taken it down. And to reclaim map control slowly but surely. That's the plan, ladies and gentlemen. That's the plan. Okay. Looks like we are stronger on this side. That's pretty nice. What are these units? Okay. Alright, let's go. Now is the time to shine. A new power is arising and victory is at hand. We have even more units around this side. Okay, now is the time to shine. Now we gotta do something. Now we need to make something happen. We need one of these to put them inside the tower. He was just recapturing this outpost or citadel, but we can take it down right after. If I hear Nazgul. But it's a Nazgul behind because I'm blind. Go, go, Saruman. Okay, I'm actually curious about the damage. Are they even able to shoot? They are able to shoot indeed. Nice. Okay, let's capture this one too. We are growing rich. That's how the Tainted Land is looking like, by the way. It looks very, very different. So we have taken down this outpost, which is pretty nice. And you guys can go inside the genes here, just in front of his castle. And we can maybe even make one of them and put one of them inside this one as well. But you can see, like, if you want to have a challenge, this is, you know, if the thing is, if you just change the command points and increase it big time, now the opponent Mordor has 800 command points just like you do have. The thing is that this is going to make it so much more challenging because they will spam units on the field all the time, especially on a map like this, where they have also lots of money. They will never run out of money, actually, you know. Okay, let's get this. Also, put them inside this one, maybe. Come on. Come on, baby. All right, let's go. Oh, we couldn't buy it? Really? Ah, maybe my bad. We are getting so much money now, guys. We have, like, all map control. Pretty much all map control. Let's go now for Siege Forks. We have work to do. Let's go for Siege Forks. Triple Siege Forks. Just why not? We have so much money at this point. And we're gonna bomb him. That's the punishment for actually spamming lots of units on us all the time. We're gonna bomb him, boys. Bomb him. We will send lots of explosive mines on his face. Okay, we have also... look, we have, like... we put everywhere units inside, you know? Like, every tower at the top side has our units inside. Oh, he's attacking us. It's fine. We can defend this, no problemo. Okay, now we are talking. Now, what is the shortcut for Ballista? B. That's the only unit we will be recruiting from now on. Okay, here, let's make more furnaces so we are, you know, kind of rich and we can do whatever we want. Let's also use the Devastation. I want to use it maybe on his trees. Just steal his trees, you know, so he has no more money. Okay. All right, like, guys. I want to see... wait a second. I want to see that. The damage of that against the... structures. Okay, it doesn't do anything. Against structures, it didn't do anything. Anything. But the range is crazy. Did you guys see that? Hold on a second. I will show you guys. This great amount of... but watch the range. Now we are out of the range, right? Look, watch the range of Saruman. Auto attack, by the way. Do you see that? Auto attack range, by the way. It doesn't deal any damage, but his auto attack range is crazy. He can attack the structures out of the range. I mean, he's busy killing this tower. He will eventually be able to kill it. That's why we will need to defend it, I guess. Uruks, let's go, guys, here to respond. Spot. I can't even talk. English hard. This game was actually kind of nuts, kind of crazy. Kind of very scary game, also. Now we have Ballistas. Ballistas are also dealing negative damage to the structures, by the way. Look how much damage the Ballista dealt to the furnace. Do you see that? LOL. Are you kidding me, dude? Balanced, by the way. Balanced. Let's see them also bleeds. We will need Berserkers. You know, the plan is simple. Make a Berserker army worthy of Mordor. Okay, so you guys, go, 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 go. We have so much money at this point, that's dope. More Uruk warriors. Okay, we will need more Ballistas. How many Ballistas do we need to get it to level 2? I believe only 2, right? Will it be level 2 now after the second one? If yes, we will make the transition into the explosive mines. Okay, now we can make explosive mines. Just kill everything. I mean, Saruman can also attack this literally from where he's standing. He's also not hitting very hard against structures. I'm hungry. Okay. It takes like 1 hour to destroy a furnace level 3 with like 6 Ballistas. What? That's crazy. Why is that? Oh, we have so much money at this point. He has only one single settlement. Uruks. Come on now, get to level 2 already. Like, I wanna just sacrifice these, to be honest with you guys. They are like useless at this point. Just go inside and sacrifice yourself. Okay, let's go for the big guns. What is that? D for deploy. Okay, D for deploy. Let's go. What is the other one? D for deploy. I want to see the damage of them. Of these explosive mines. If they don't one-shot a level 3 furnace, I'm speechless. Seriously. We leveled up the siege works. Elf Sauron is scouting. That's all it can do. I see you, but you can't do anything about me. You can just see me. More explosive mines are required. Let's go like this. Let's go inside. Let's try to keep him busy. This way he won't be able to see the mines. And then we will actually make him so he's gonna be boom, 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 you know? And he will be falling apart. Here. We need more explosive mines, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, we are kind of broke. Let's use devastation to change it. Isengard, I love Isengard. Like, as Isengard, you have so many tools to actually get money, boys. You see, you know, you have devastation, you have field of fires, you have pillage from lords, you have industry from the spellbook, holy guacamole, you have lumber mills generally, which are giving you a lot of money. Of course, the downside is that you eventually will run out of trees at some point, you know? But other than that, it's just awesome. It's just awesome. Can you get deployed? Come on, you can get deployed, right? Okay. You also can get deployed here. And you also can get deployed here. Okay, just kill the Haradrim Palace into Orc Pit. This way, he can't stop us, you know? He can't stop our explosive mines. You know the plan is like chain reaction, you know? Chain reaction makes sense, right? In the chain reaction, what is the goal is that you put enough mines that you need to trigger only one of them, and then they will have like a chain, like, you know, go to school, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about. And for that reason, we need these units, the Berserkers. That's how they will celebrate. And all they need to do is reach to one single explosive mine only, and then it's going to be boom, 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 chakalaka time. He's building towers all he wants, but if they didn't hard nerf the damage of the explosive mines, it should be easy peasy lemon squeezy, you know? Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Just put there. Just put here. We need more, 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 just to make sure, you know, that everything is working flawlessly. Okay, we need one more here, I believe. Okay, Warp Riders, you can peel back, man. Okay. We need one right here. And we need one right here. And one right here. I believe that's going to be enough, hopefully. He's building yet another tower, though, to make it not that fun for us. That's why we have to eventually build more. Get this mine, or, you know, there we go. Come on now. So, we secured this side. So, this is going to chain react, you know, all these. So, we need to now find a connection, which means we need to make sure that we trigger, for example, this one is gonna trigger this one, and so on. That's the plan, you know? Easy to understand. You guys are smart. I know you guys are smart, so you know what I'm talking about. So, for that reason, let's build, put one around this side, just to make sure that we have the chain reaction we need. And also, you can go right here. Okay, he's building more towers. It's kind of boring. Don't do that. I know this takes some time, but it was frustrating for me at the beginning, so I will definitely make it happen, guys. Trust me on the O1, okay? Hopefully, it's not gonna fail. Come on now. More, 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 more. Let's put one here. I don't know if they have the chain reaction here. Maybe we need to put one more here. I don't know. I can't tell. We will find out, huh? And imagine if they deal like zero damage. Imagine we would just waste. I would just waste an hour of my life, literally. It feels like that, to be honest with you. You know. Wait, hold on. Maybe here. Maybe we still need one more there, to be honest. Like here. And you go right here. Easy. You go right here. Right here. Okay, you can see the explosive mines are tanky against towers. You know, they will eventually still die at some point, but for now they are tanky. So just make sure. So we have enough. Do we have... Now we have no here. So we need definitely one there, you know. Right here. Right. This way this tower can also die. This tower will die. This tower will die. This tower should also be dead. This tower should also be dead. I believe it's going to be done. I think we need, like, just to make sure that it's really connecting everything, we need, like, little bit more. Like, four more or something, you know? Like, here. And you go right here. So, there is a connection, right? Yeah, there is a connection. So you can go right here. Let's get rid of this thing. And you can go right. Is that a connection? There is a connection, I believe. Hopefully it's gonna be a good connection. Okay. Okay, these are we send only two more, okay? We send only two more, and then we are good to go. You and you, and that's it. That's it. I think we have now enough. Enough to do what we like to do. Okay. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. It's time, it's time, it's time. Okay, did you guys ever see? I mean, I've done something similar to that in a 1v7 video long time ago, and I enjoyed it a lot. I hope you will, sorry for hitting the microphone. I hope you will also enjoy this a lot. If you do, you know, if you do guys like content like this on this channel, please don't forget to leave likes and also subscribe for more content like this. And I want to say thank you for watching in advance, because I believe that now the Berserkers, they will get the job done. They will get the job done. They will get the job done. If they don't get the job done, it would be kind of bad for me, because I mean, I hope they will get the job done. I hope they will get the job done. We will find out together. Let's use Palantir. Okay. The Hour of Truth, Explosive Mines, Berserkers are going inside the jeans, and... Come on. Come on. Boom, 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 boom. Just like that, Mordor has fallen, and Isengard, the White Hand of Saruman, is victorious. I will see you guys next time. Until then, keep... hitting like a truck. Oof, look at our money. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.